I came back from Boston and talked to somebody called John Edge, who some of you may know, who's another entrepreneur, and it just seemed that it would be a good idea to get the regulators, the government, and the private sector together in a room, just so that they could talk about this stuff. At that stage, it was very much a question of understanding what was going on and what was happening. It's very different now. And one of the things we learned was that one of the big challenges you have as a bank is when a customer comes to you and says they want to do business with you and they'd like to use your services, and then they mention that, for example, Bitcoin is part of their proposition. You have to understand that in the regulatory environment at the moment, there is a general sense of caution about Bitcoin. We talked about this before. I think it's changing, moving forward. So the Whitechapel think tank, the banks came and said, look, somehow we've got to be able to bank these customers. And in that meeting, the Whitechapel think tank with the Bank of England and the Financial Conduct Authority, the FCA. And the FCA said, look, let's take this away. And they came back to the following meeting and said, the one message we need to convey to all of you is we do not want any of you stifling innovation. Would you please do all you can to encourage these customers to come to the table? And this wasn't the only reason, but the FCA then set up their sandbox. The Bank of England has consistently said, since then, we're listening. Of course we don't want you to put major risks that are going to upset the system, but there is serious material innovation going on here. And that led us to the next learning, if that's the right way to do it, William, which is that the British government is very pro this, and is keen to have this developed as much as possible. FinTech generally, but is now beginning to understand the sheer scale of the opportunities in blockchain for better government, for simply servicing the electorate. And so they have engaged much more through the Whitechapel think tank, but also bilaterally.